So there's a handy new feature for users that have a Mac running Sierra and you've got an Apple Watch and the watch is running watchOS 3, the latest version that just came out. You can unlock your Mac instead of entering your password. Your watch does it for you automatically. Now, there are a lot of catches. Like, for instance, you have to be using two-factor authentication with your Apple ID, not two-step authentication, which is the older version that Apple had and still has both. But if you're using two-factor authentication and you've set everything up correctly, then it can work. It's kind of tricky. So you set it up in System Preferences, and it's actually only in one spot in System Preferences. Under Security and Privacy, under General, you've got Allow your Apple Watch to unlock your Mac. Now you may or may not see this present. Everything's got to be set up just right. So you have to have two-factor authentication turned on and that should appear. Sometimes people report that even if you've turned on two-factor authentication recently, you need to restart your Mac before you'll see this. And even after restarting, it might take a few minutes for this to show up as certain checks are done before it actually shows you this in System Preferences. But when this does happen, really there's no other setting for it. You sit down at your Mac that's asleep and say you hit the space bar, wake it up, and instead of getting your password prompt, you'll get a sound from your Apple Watch and a message like this that shows that your machine was unlocked by your Apple Watch. If it doesn't work, you might get a message saying that you know, your Apple Watch hasn't been signed into yet because you haven't entered your passcode yet today or logged in with your iPhone or some other message, and you simply have to enter your password as before. So the worst case scenario is you have to do exactly what you did before, enter in your password on your Mac, and the best case scenario is your Mac unlocks for you automatically every time you sit down at your desk. For more information, you can go to this Apple support page, which has some more details and troubleshooting tips. Thank you.